Coming into a program, coming as pro-Palestinian, is definitely good to get your, you know, your beliefs tested almost.
And I think that's a really powerful message, and something I really care about. And it's so true that if we care about ideas more than people, then what are our ideas worth?
And helping people is what I'm going to do. And he's always wanted a Nike Karachis, and I went to town with him, and he walked in the store and I walked straight back out, and I went to a charity shop. Instead, he bought £100 for Vani to donation, and he goes, I realised I didn't need the shoes, I've been wanting them for ages, but I just want to help other people, and for me to inspire someone else is great. So I live by the quote, to be inspired is good, but to inspire other people is great.
I really like to go on another places to tell what is really happening. For instance, I met in my year of an unknown town in France who has built a humanitarian refugee camp, and I would like to share a story, so call me.
Do you know where you come from? How would you appreciate where you're going? That's the last thing my dad told me before he passed away. Despite belonging to anything like this, despite being a working class, despite having everything against me, I've proven everyone wrong, my teachers and even myself. I was like, Indian man, I was told I would never make it to sixth form. Not just down to my ability, but down to my attitude.
I've always been impressed and knew how they managed to bring together people who have such an enthusiasm for understanding doing something about this issue, and why wouldn't we give time to something like that?
This program is very important because it lets you see so many different perspectives, which I think is the only way to kind of reach a solution. If it wasn't for this program, I wouldn't have met people like Daoud and Michal and basically anyone who came here, because I feel like it just allowed me to grow so much. And the only thing I really say is I wish we had more time, another week or two with the program.
Actually, I couldn't have asked for a better organisation or a better way for me to learn about the conflict and what's going on, because I don't think there is anything else out there like this in the UK. I know if you want to learn about conflict or you don't know where to start, you just go on Google and you Google it, and then I didn't want to do that because I didn't want to, you know, hear other people's opinions through reading trash news. I wanted to form my own opinions, and that this is by far the best way I've found to do it.
I think Solutions Not Sides taught me that often in an attempt to understand things, we simplify them. And coming on this residential made me realise the complexity to the situation in Palestine. I think often when you have your own views, what's comforting is to reaffirm them within a bubble of views that surround yours, even if you don't realise it. And I was massively taken out of my own realm of thought, in a sense, and I really learned from that. And one thing that particularly struck me from the programme was when Dolph, one of the other students, said that, you know, we can all recognise that on both sides there's suffering and there's pain, but we have to ask ourselves, what do we want to do? What do I want to do about it? And that has definitely made me passionate about engaging with the other side and looking into solutions as opposed to staying in possibly a bubble of thought.